So, hopefully you watched the intro video for the unit and then did this assignment. And now hopefully after doing the assignment, now hopefully you're watching so you can kind of make sure you know what's going on. Now, I don't have the whole worksheet on this screen. I have just the picture of the graph or the graph, the chart, the table. And so I'm going to be drawing on it and like kind of doing what it says to do. And hopefully you'll follow along and figure something out here. So I'm going to be looking off to the side here because I have the actual worksheet here so I can see what the questions were. All right, so it says in a neutral sodium atom, how many protons and electrons are there? Neutral sodium. And so again, sodium's number 11 here. So sodium being the, oh no, I'm going to have to move myself. I'm going to have to move myself over. I'm going to have to move myself to the corner because I got to be able to get to the tools here. Oh gosh, come on. This thing, I tell you, it's nothing but frustration. Okay. So, sodium, it has 11 protons and 11 electrons. Protons are pluses, electrons are minuses.
Yeah.
Right? Hopefully you said that. So, a neutral sodium atom, 11 of each. 11 protons, 11 electrons, pluses and minuses. Now, what would happen to the charge of the sodium atom if it were to lose one electron? If it loses one, then it goes from 11 electrons down to what?
Need my eraser. Goes from 11 down to what? Ten. Oh my gosh. I tell you, this. From 11 down to 10.
So, goes down to 10 electrons, which means the charge on sodium would be what? Plus one, right? Positive one. Positive one. There's one more plus than minus. Has to be a charge, excuse me, of positive one. Okay, now what? Using the table above, sketch a new picture of the sodium atom after losing the electron. Well, instead of sketching a new picture, I'm just going to use the magic of the smart board. And I am going to draw, oh my gosh, using some white ink, I'm going to draw white over that outermost electron there and just pretend, oh, I guess I could go back to the black ink and draw a little, oh, I can't get any finer than what it is right now, so it's probably gonna look. Oh, how about that?
That's not bad. So, oh, that's terrible.
Oh, I know what I need to do. Hold on, let me undo that. I need to pick just a dark gray. That's what I need.
That's not bad. That's pretty good. So you can still see a little bit of red though. What in the world? Oh, yeah. This. Oh, jeez. It's good enough for who it's for. It's just you guys. So that's what it would look like. Now the next question is, based on your new picture of sodium, how many electrons are in the outer level? Answer to that is, well, let's see, two, four, six, eight. Oh, look at that. There's eight in the outer level after that one leaves. Okay. So in a neutral sulfur atom, how many protons and electrons are there? Okay, so now we're over here on sulfur, neutral sulfur.
Well, there's 16 protons, and then there's 16 electrons, right? Protons are plus, electrons are minus.
Okay. And what would happen to the charge of a sulfur atom if it were to gain 2 electrons? Gain 2 electrons. So instead of 16, now it's
18. So now it's 18 electrons, not 16 anymore.
That makes sulfur a charge of what? Negative 2, I hope you're saying.
Right. That makes a negative 2 charge here.
Hmm. Because it gained 2. And then it says, using the table above, sketch a new picture of sulfur after gaining the 2 electrons. Well, where are those 2 electrons going to go? Well, it's probably going to look like what argon does right there.
There's going to be another one here and another one here. So I guess I'll go to my red ink and say, okay, there's another one right here beside this one. And then there's another one right here beside this one.
Oh, look at that. That looks pretty good. So now there's 1, or 2, I should say, 4, 6, 8. Oh, look at that. So based on your new picture of sulfur, how many electrons are in the outer shell? 8. Just showed it. Counted them. That's interesting. So sodium had 8 in its outer level after the 1 got lost. Sulfur has 8 now in the outer level after 2 of them got added or gained here. Okay. So what group of elements have the most electrons in their outer energy level? Well, it's the noble gases, which we'd already talked about, right? They have full outer levels, or an octet. Full, again, because helium can only hold 2 in the first level, so it's full. The rest of them, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, all of those have 8 in the outermost energy level, which we consider full. Now, look at number 10 here, or the paragraph on the next sheet. It talks about how noble gases have a full outer level, and that everything else on the table wants to be like that. All of the rest of the elements on the table are aspiring to have their electron configuration look like the noble gas electron configuration. They want a full octet in their outermost energy level. Now, it says, hopefully you've read that. So when atoms give or take electrons, they have a charge. And we call those ions, which, again, you already knew. We talked about how a charged atom is called an ion. And so for these atoms to either to have an octet, they're going to have to either gain or lose electrons to make it happen. We just saw that when sodium lost 1, it now has a full octet. We see sulfur here. It gained 2 electrons, and now it has a full octet. Hopefully you're seeing that. Now it asks you about a few others. It says oxygen is in the same group as sulfur. What do you think oxygen would do to achieve a full outer level? How many is in the outer level for oxygen? 6, right?
So there's only 6 out here. And so if we, let me get back to my red, oh, I'm already on it. So if oxygen gains, I'm a little small, if it gains 2 electrons like what sulfur did, then 2, 4, 6, 8. So now it has 8 in its outermost level, 2, 4, 6, 8.
So that makes oxygen have a full octet by gaining 2 electrons as well, which makes it what charge? Negative 2.
So that means we have a negative 2 charge there,
not just for sulfur, but oxygen too. And if you look down below sulfur, all right, oh, where are we? Selenium. So as you get further down the family, all of them have 6 electrons in their outermost level. And so all of them, by gaining 2 electrons, can have an octet. So if and when they do that, they will become a negative 2 charge. Let's see. How about magnesium? It's 1 group over from sodium. What do you think magnesium is going to do to have an octet? Well, there's two electrons out there, right, in the outermost level. So how easily do you think that magnesium could gain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? Do you think magnesium is going to gain 6 electrons? I doubt it. It's going to be way easier. Magnesium is going to most likely lose the 2 that it already has. And when it does,
let me get back to my white ink here. When it loses these 2 that are out here, when it loses those, now let me get back to my gray. That's not bad. That's pretty good.
I got to admit, that's not bad. So when it loses those 2 that are out there, notice what it has in outer level. It has an octet, 2, 4, 6, 8. It has an octet. But to do that, it had to lose 2 electrons. When you lose minuses, you become what? When you lose minuses, you're going to become plus 2. And that's not just going to happen for magnesium, but for everything in that family. Like beryllium is going to do the same thing. These outer 2, gone, which leaves it a full first level. Calcium, which is below magnesium, same thing. It's got 2 in the outer level. Those 2 are going to get taken away. It will have a full outer level then, a full octet, and it will become a +2 charge. The whole family. All right, nitrogen. Okay, so now we're looking at nitrogen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It has 5 in the outer level. It wants an octet. What do you think nitrogen would most likely do to get an octet? Probably gain 3 electrons.
Yeah, I agree. It's going to gain 3 electrons. That would make the most sense for nitrogen. And so, ooh, I got to get that out of the way. So, going to gain 1 here. Going to gain 1 here. And going to gain 1 here.
Now, what do you see around the nitrogen? We have, again, 2, 4, 6, 8. We now have an octet, but it did that by gaining 3 electrons. When you gain 3 minuses, 3 negative charges, you become a what charge?
-3.
There is a pattern, number 15 says. There is a pattern on the periodic table for the charge of ions. Elements that are in the same group will have the same charge. Look at the elements that you have calculated that charge for and determine what the periodic pattern is. Label each column on the periodic table with the charge. So, look at the halogens, for instance. Look at the halogens.
How many do they need to satisfy an octet? They have currently 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They have 7,
which means they need 1 more to make an octet.
So fluorine will pick up 1 electron, boom, there's an octet. Chlorine can pick up 1 electron, boom, make an octet.
If they gain 1 electron, that makes them what charge? They gain 1 negative, more than they had before. They were neutral. They gain 1 negative, they're going to become a -1. How about that? Now, we already looked at sodium, and again, sodium, it lost 1 electron, probably had something stolen from it. See, these over here, they're looking for electrons, okay? The only way they're going to get their octet taken care of is if they gain some electrons. Where do you think they're going to get them? These poor schmucks over here, all right? So, sodium, it's going to have 1 stolen from it, and maybe it'll be upset, but then it'll also be like, hey, you know what? That's all right, because now I have an octet, and that's what I wanted all along anyway. Remember, all of these atoms, they want to be like the noble gases in their electron configuration. They want the octet. They want that perfect octet. So they'll do what it takes to get that. Now, again, if you look at lithium here, all right, lithium having a single electron out there in the outer level, just like sodium does. If that electron gets stolen, then the inner 2
become now the outer two, and it becomes like helium with a stable full first level. So remember, that's the exception to the octet. Lithium and beryllium and boron, they can become like helium in its electron configuration by losing these electrons they have out there, or having them stolen in some cases. So if all of this first family loses one electron to make the octet happen, then this whole group is going to become a, remember this one was a plus two, so this one's going to become a plus one.
Let me go back to gray. That's going to be a plus one up here.
Now look at the boron group. So boron and aluminum, what's going to happen here? Now they have three in there, three. So are they going to gain five, or are these three going to get stolen? More, it's more likely that these three that it has in the outer level, that those three are going to get stolen by these punks over here, right? And then these will have an octet after that happens. There's no way, they're not going to be able to find five. One, two, three, four, five. They're not going to get five electrons to complete that octet. That's not going to happen. They're going to get pickpocketed. You got the pickpocketers. You got the pickpocketed. Got to be frustrating. But it's okay, because once those are gone, they will have an octet. Okay, so that means this one, this column, this group, the boron group, they become a plus three.
Plus three. Because again, I guess I can change back to boron here. It's going to have these three electrons stolen by probably one of those other three columns over here, because they're jerks, I guess. Let's do a little.
Good enough, I guess, for who it's for. So look at that. So those three electrons outermost are gone. Now the outermost is the first level, which is full with two. It becomes like helium stable electron configuration, but it became a plus three charge in the process because it lost three minuses. So remember, when you lose minuses, you become positive. When you gain minuses, you become negative. Now remember, it's only the electrons that are doing this, just like with the balloon and the hair, okay? The balloon can't transfer protons to the hair to make it positive, all right? Remember, the protons are stuck in the nucleus. It's the electrons that are doing all this stuff because they're all the way on the outside of the atom. Like, they're way out here. They're not stuck in the nucleus in the center. They're on the outside, and they can come and go fairly easily. That leads us to one more column. What happens here? We got a carbon group here that have four electrons out there. Four electrons. What are they going to do? Are they going to have four stolen? Or are they going to try to steal four? Like, is one of those easier than the other? No, it's pretty equal, which is why that group, they could do either. They could have four electrons stolen from them, or they could have four electrons given, or they could steal four electrons. So it could be a plus or a minus four for that group. They're kind of, again, four is halfway to eight. So it could go either way. They could steal four, or they could have four stolen from them. But this, hopefully you're seeing the pattern. Obviously a plus one, plus two, plus three, plus or minus four, and then a minus three, minus two, minus one. That's the pattern. Okay, that is the periodic pattern on the table. So we will talk more about that next time, but hopefully this makes sense, that you see that there's a pattern and that these atoms are going to get charged when they have a full octet by either stealing electrons from somebody else or having electrons stolen. One of the two things is going to happen, and then they will have a full octet. Notice though, the noble gases, what's going on over here? Nothing. Because they already have an octet. There's no plus or minus here because they're not gaining or losing anything. They already have an octet. They're done. So That's it. We'll see you next time. Take care.